Hey everyone, Erin Bassett here, and I'm going to show you today how you can customize a children's tea set that's perfect for playing with your little one. Okay, so to get started, we are going into Canvas Workspace and clicking on the Pattern Collections. And this is where I got my doily from. It's from the Tattered Lace Pattern Collection number 1. You can see it right there in the little icon picture of it. And here it is. Enlarged, and I'm using this doily, but there's plenty of other doilies in the other design collections, and you can even use flowers or anything like that. So I'm just going to download the whole thing into my computer and then unzip it and be able to use it from there. Now I'm also going to click on filter in Canvas Workspace and just pull up some of the flower ones. And I need this one that is the flower pattern tumbler. And I am going to edit all those parts in Canvas Workspace. But you can also save it just like you did with the other pattern to your computer or to USB. So once I have this open up in Canvas Workspace, I'm just going to resize these. So I need them to be about an inch. So I'm just going to do one of each of the patterns and then multiply it out for how many I need. I have 4 cups and 4 saucers. So I'm using both the pink part and the white part for each flower. So I'm going to need 4 small ones and then 1 big one for the teapot. Okay, and I'm going up here to the SVG button, and that will allow me to bring in that doily that I saved. And so I'm just recalling that, and I'm going to put it in the lower quadrant. Each one of these quadrants will have a different type of material in order to cut this out. Okay, and I'm going to use that same flower to be little doilies under my little cups on top of the saucers. So I'm going to make those about 1 3/4 inch. And again, I'm going to need 4 of those. Okay, so now that they're all situated, I can send it over via ScanNCut transfer over to my ScanNCut. Then over on my machine, I'll click the retrieving button and it'll pop right up. Okay, so my top quadrants, my 2 top ones, those will be vinyl and the bottom ones are paper. So I'm going to cut them out individually because I need to change my blade depth. So I could click on it and hit the trash can and delete each one like that. Or if I want to select all of them or some of them, I can use the little cursor arrows to be able to crop it down and choose just those ones that I want to delete. Okay, so I have the vinyl ones still left. White vinyl on the left, pink vinyl on the right. And of course I've loaded that on my mat that way. And now I'm ready to cut it out. So the next thing we need to do is weed it out, and it's helpful to just bend back the corner to get it started. You can usually get a little piece of the vinyl up like that and then just slowly peel it off. Now for the white one, it has so many little parts to it. So I am just going to trim down my vinyl piece so I don't have so much to work with. I'm just going to bend that corner to be able to separate it from the backing. Okay, so for all those little bits that I need to get out, you can kind of bend it backwards and try to pop them out, but it is really hard. I really recommend getting a hook tool, and Brother makes this obviously, and it makes it super simple to just be able to, you know, pick at these and be able to get them out. So I'm just going to take some of those out. And once you get, you know, some of the bigger ones out, you can, because this is a small piece, kind of use it like a sticker instead of using transfer tape like you would with a larger one, just so it would keep its shape and not stretch out or anything. You can use it like a sticker and just pick it right up. So you might still have some that you need to poke out like I'm doing. Just be careful because that tool is sharp. And then when you're ready, you can go ahead and put that top layer on top of the pink layer. So I'm just going to take out the middle. I'm going to save that because I can put other flowers on it. And then you just need to line it up. So you can see on the pink one, you have this one little point that sticks out. And so you just have to match that up with the same white flower point and have those match. And then it'll all line up. So there we go. So once you have it all layered up, you're ready to put it on your teapot. And again, since this is a small little design, you can just use it just like a sticker and transfer it onto your teapot. Now, if you had enlarged this to use it on a large teapot, you'd probably want to use your gridded transfer paper to do that. And it'll make it go on much easier without fighting with it. Okay, so now we have our teapot done. And again, I just repeated the process for all of the teacups. Okay, so back to my ScanNCut machine. I'm just gonna go back home and now retrieve that same design again. My ScanNCut still remembers that it has it in there. And now I want to delete the top half because we already completed that. So I'm just gonna select all of those and then hit delete. So now we can work with the paper ones. And again, I put white paper on the right and pink paper on the left. And then when you're ready, just go ahead and hit cut. Make sure you adjust your blade and start. And you can see how cute those turned out. Okay, so now we want to go ahead and take out that word flower in Canvas workspace so that we get all the designs popping up. And one of the recent designs is this Mother's Day pop-up card box or box card. And it has some really cute flowers right there and some leaves. So you just need to download the leaves and the flowers, not all the other bits. And again, just do the same thing that we did. Open it up in Canvas if you want to, transfer it that way, or you can also save it onto USB and pop the USB into your ScanNCut to use it. So I am going to transfer it via ScanNCut transfer. And so then again, I'll just go onto my ScanNCut and retrieve them. Okay, there they are. So, okay, cut, and I'm ready to go. Oh, just gotta load my mat. And start. Okay, so once it's done cutting, you can just unload your mat and take it over to your workspace. Now, I'm sure you could probably figure this out. It is just layering your flowers. So you're gonna put some adhesive on the back of each layer and layer them up how you desire. And then that little 2-inch piece of green cardstock, you're just gonna stick your flowers on the top half. So it might be handy to measure out on your green piece of paper exactly how deep it will go into your flower pot so you know how to put the flowers on. Now you can see I popped up some of my flowers using this foam adhesive, and I just did that on a couple of them to give it a little more dimension. And also for the leaves, I folded them to give them dimension as well. I also added some cute little embellishments, some little pearls and diamond like gems to the top of it, and those were just stick-on ones. So as I was packing this up, I thought, oh, it'd be cute to have a little tag on the outside of this. So I whipped this up real quick, and here's how I did it.
I really quick went ahead and cut out the tag piece already for this. Now I'm going to use my universal pen tool to be able to write on it. And you can see I already have the writing on my screen right there. I'm just going to uncap my pen, put it in. You'll see the tip touches right there. And then I can just take this, pull it up and over until my pen's locked in place. And I just remove the base from that and take out my cutting blade, put in my pen holder, and close the little latch. Now I'm ready to draw this. I just need to remove the tag piece because I don't need it to draw that. So you can see it selected it. I'm just gonna hit delete. So now I have my words and I can click OK, OK. And now I'm going to hit draw instead of cut. And start. I went ahead and added a flower embellishment that I had left over from my project, added some string, and it'll be perfect to tie on to my little tea party set.
And here's how our whole set turned out. It's perfect for our next tea party. Now, for more information about ScanNCut, visit scanandcut.com. And for more ideas and inspiration, visit erinbassett.com.